At 9:14 this morning, there is an oasis in South Memphis's food desert.
That is for sure. Memphis grocer Rick James opened his fourth cash saver in the 1900 block of South 3rd, the site of the old Kroger that recently shut down. Rick, welcome to Live at 9 this morning. So glad to have you here.
Good morning. Thanks.
For those who don't know, for those who have somehow not heard the story, what was missing in that area? Why was this needed?
Well, once that store was closed, it became a food desert. And what that means is that there are not enough nutritional options for shoppers. Mm-hmm. One of the things that's really significant about that particular part of the city is transportation. A lot of these customers, it was five and a half miles to the nearest grocery store, full service store.
That is insane.
Some people would say.
But sometimes it's 2 hours to make that trip.
Right.
So it brings it back to the neighborhood.
Because we're talking about, you know, there are small convenience stores, but we're talking about fresh meat. We're talking about produce. The things that we really should be eating just weren't readily available.
That's exactly right.
So you hear cash saver, and some people who maybe have never shopped are thinking secondhand brands, you know. So tell us what your model is.
Okay, well, it's a full-line supermarket. Mm-hmm. We do a cost-plus program. I'm kind of a numbers nerd, so it was fun to sit down, and we decided to assign a cost to each item from its source, from the manufacturer to the shelf, and those are different. Mm-hmm. Some items come in from the bread guy. He delivers it, he puts it up, he stocks it, and so we don't have a lot of involvement. But then a certified Angus beef boneless chuck roast, we have to pay the freight, we have to pay a journeyman meat cutter to cut it, wrap it, tray it. So once we said if we can define that cost difference for each item, then at the point of the shelf, we'll be at the lowest possible price that we could be on every item in the store.
Huh.
Wow.
We add 10% at the front end, helps to cover
the
overhead.
Pay your employees, all that.
Right. So this sounds like it really could work out for the consumer for sure. Let's talk about healthy recipes, though. Are any of those going to be provided as well? Because a lot of times you'll go to a store these days, you want to make sure you're eating as healthy as possible, or you're preparing recipes at home that are healthy for your families. What about that?
Absolutely. One thing on our website, we do have a healthy eating segment. We also do in the fall, we do health fairs along with one of the local radio stations that brings nutritionists in to the store. And then many of the manufacturers now provide a lot of healthy tips, whether it's how to use produce, whether it's how to incorporate items into an old recipe, maybe an old family recipe that wasn't really healthy, but here's a way to do it more healthy.
You mean here in the South? you know, I think Alex Coleman doing live food demonstrations, I think that would be cool.
Okay.
Cooking demos.
Well, definitely.
Just a marketing idea.
Absolutely.
So, Rick, you also see this maybe going to other communities in the city or in the Mid-South? What's next?
One of the things interesting about Cash Saver is the very first one was opened in Memphis, 1620 Madison Avenue. There are now over 100 Cash Savers across the country who all came to Memphis to tour that store because the idea is perfect for neighborhoods where food options are needed and where low prices are absolutely necessary for that customer. When we save a customer on their food bill, we know that in the inner city stores where we operate, that then allows that customer to pay for rent, pay for transportation, buy clothes, shoes for the kids.
Utilities, so, all that stuff.
So we know that we're expanding their ability to thrive.
So it's about more than food.
It is more about food.
You have really put it in perspective this morning. Rick, thank you.
And they're having a grand opening where they want everybody to come out and have fun, not just shop. So there is the time and the date for that. Thank you so much.
And maybe sample some food.
Absolutely.
Let us know.
Absolutely.
Get some recipes.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that.